गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू ऑनलाइन क्लास ऑफ सोशल स्टडीज़ ऑफ क्लास फिफ्थ। होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड एट योर होम। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू लेसन नंबर 7 and 8, एक्सरसाइजेज एंड क्वेश्चन आंसर्स। इन माई प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव कम्प्लीटेड योर लेसन नंबर 6। सो नॉट फॉर द डिले, टेक आउट योर बुक, कॉपी एंड पेन ऑल्सो एंड ओपन लेसन नंबर 7 एक्सरसाइजेज। हियर इज़ योर लेसन नंबर 7 ऑन पेज नंबर 58। You can see your question is multiple choice question. First is the part 3 of the Constitution of the India mentions about the fundamental right. Here B you have to tick this one. Then second question, the state shall not discriminate against any citizen on ground of religion, race, caste, sex or place of birth. This provision has been mentioned in the right to equality. Next, the right against exploitation projects again employment of children below 14 years. Now come on next page. Here, if we, top of the paper, if we all discharge our duties, rights will not be far to seek. Who mentioned this statement? Gandhiji. Then, in which part of the Constitution of India the fundamental duties are mentioned? Part 4th A. Here you have to tick. Now next, tick and wrong. First question, unteachability and its practices in any form has been abolished, right? We cannot form association or unions, wrong. We must promote harmony and spirit of brotherhood, right. It is our fundamental duty to respect the national flag and the national anthem, right. India is a secular state, right. Fill in the blanks. You all have to write it neatly. Fill in the blanks is, first is the fundamental rights have been guaranteed to us by the Constitution of India. Here you can write all numbers also. Second, the state shall not confer title on anybody. Third, right against exploitation is a fundamental right. Fourth, all minorities have the right to establish educational institution of their choice. Fifth, rights and duties are the two sides of the same coin. So student, the numbering of this box is 3, 4, 1, 5, 2. It will not come in your exam, box will not come in your exam helping box. You have to learn it yourself, okay? Now come on next page. Next exercise, match the following. Right to equality, here you have to write in this way numbers, okay? All persons shall be equal before the law. Right to freedom, this one, move freely throughout the territory of India. Right of freedom of religion, freedom to manage religious affairs. Right to information, come into force on 12th October 2005. Fundamental duty to value and preserve the rich heritage of a composite culture. Okay students, so these are the exercise of lesson number 7. Now come on question answers. Your first question is here. You can see here. First question is, write in brief about the right to equality. The right to equality, the all the persons shall be equal before the law. So persons equal hai, and the person shall have equal protection of law within the territory of India. Law ke according sab persons ko equal protection milti hai territory of India, India ki territory mein. Now next, right provisions are included in the right of freedom. So the right to freedom, all citizens shall have the right to freedom of speech and expressions, assemble peacefully and without arms, and resides and settle in any part of the territory of India. Okay, this is the answer of second question. Now third, what all can be practiced under right to freedom of religion. So right to freedom of religion, A, freedom to manage religious affairs, B, freedom not to pay taxes for religious promotion. Okay students, so you can take a screenshot to write the question answer of lesson number 7. Now fifth question answer, here fourth and fifth. Write in brief about the importance, the fundamental duties. So according to Gandhiji, the importance, the source of light is a duty. If we all discharge our duties, rights will not be far to seek. Thus, rights and duties are two sides of the same coin. एंड आर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन हैज लेट डाउन 11 फंडामेंटल ड्यूटीज फॉर एवरी सिटीजन ऑफ इंडिया. नाउ फिफ्थ, मेंशन एनी 5 फंडामेंटल ड्यूटीज. ए, 5 यू हैव टू मेंशन हियर, टू अपलोड एंड प्रोटेक्ट द सोवरेनिटी, यूनिटी एंड इंटीग्रिटी ऑफ इंडिया. नेक्स्ट, टू डिफेंड द कंट्री एंड रेंडर नेशनल सर्विसेज व्हेन कॉल्ड अपॉन टू डू सो. नेक्स्ट, टू प्रमोट हार्मनी एंड द स्पिरिट ऑफ ब्रदरहुड अमंगस्ट ऑल द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया. डी, टू वैल्यू एंड प्रिजर्व द रिच हेरिटेज ऑफ आर कंपोजिट कल्चर. ई, टू सेव गार्ड पब्लिक प्रॉपर्टी एंड टू ऑब्जर्व वायलेंस. सो दिस इज द आंसर ऑफ क्वेश्चन नंबर 5th. यू कैन टेक स्क्रीनशॉट ऑफ 4th एंड 5th क्वेश्चन आंसर. नाउ BOQ, ब्रेन ओपनर क्वेश्चन. आर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन हैड प्रोवाइडेड अस 6 फंडामेंटल राइट्स. व्हाट इज देयर सिग्निफिकेंस इन डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री. सो द फंडामेंटल राइट हैव बीन गारंटीड टू अस बाय द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया. दीज राइट्स आर द वेरी फाउंडेशन एंड इंपॉर्टेंट फीचर ऑफ आवर डेमोक्रेटिक स्ट्रक्चर. सो द फंडामेंटल राइट्स आर बाइंडिंग ऑन द स्टेट्स. सो दीज आर द आई मीन दिस इज द आंसर ऑफ BOQ. नाउ इट इज सफिशियंट फॉर लेसन नंबर 7. इट इज ओवर. आई मीन नाउ नेक्स्ट 8th चैप्टर. नाउ आई विल गिव यू एक्सरसाइज ऑफ 8th चैप्टर एंड क्वेश्चन आंसर्स ऑल्सो. यू कैन राइट डाउन. यू ऑल, आई होप यू ऑल हैव रिटन दैट आंसर फ्रॉम द लाइव क्लासेस. यू हैव डन दैट. इफ स्टिल समथिंग इज रिमेनिंग देन यू कैन राइट फ्रॉम द यूट्यूब वीडियो. Now come on next. So student, this is your 8th chapter, basic feature, the democratic form of government. This explanation you have already got. Now exercises. 8th chapter exercise here. Multiple choice question. Which is the most rational and popular form of government? Democracy. Second, democracy is the government of the people, by the people, and for the people. Who said this? Abraham Lincoln. Now next page. Constitution may be written, unwritten, both A, B, both A and B. Next, the parliamentary democracy we mean one man, one vote. Who said this? Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. The union list comprises 97 items. Now next is train, tick and wrong. First question, the concept of democracy is also found in ancient India. Right. A constitution strictly reserved. Wrong. India is a republic. Right. Independent judiciary in the fulcrum of our democratic structure. Right. The union list comprises 66 items. Wrong. Now fill in the blanks. First, the dash form of government is widely accepted, democratic. We adopted the dash constitution, written. In the parliamentary form of government, ministers are collectively responsible to the Lok Sabha. The fundamental rights are the dash of democracy, cornerstone. The dash list comprises 47 subjects concurrent. So these are the answer of fill in the blanks. Now come on next, match the following. You can write down the number in which in this way in which I have written. First question, the most popular form of government, democracy. A constitution is both rigid and flexible. We have the parliamentary form of government both at the union and state levels. In a democratic government, all citizens enjoy certain fundamental rights. Next, in our country there is an unified judicial system. Okay, so this you have to do. Now come on question answers of 8th chapter. Here is your first question. Define the term democracy. So the answer is, democracy is the only form of government in which people feel themselves an essential part of the governmental structure. Now second question, which is the best form of the government? Explain. The democratic form of the government is the most rational and popular form of the government and is widely accepted all over the world. In this form of government, the people's participation is always ensured either directly or indirectly. So these are the answer of 8th chapter. Now next, you can take the screenshot. Third question, write in brief about the parliament form of the government. Answer, for building a united India and accommodating a variety of diversities, the parliamentary form of the government is the most suited one. In this form of the government, ministers are the collectively responsible to the Lok Sabha. Now next, fourth question, what do you mean by the universal adult franchise? Discuss. So universal franchise means the right to all eligible adults to vote in political election. यूनिवर्सल फ्रेंचाइज के अकॉर्डिंग हम एडल्ट्स वोट देने के लिए एलिजिबल हैं पॉलिटिशियन इलेक्शन में. नाउ फिफ्थ क्वेश्चन, व्हाट इज़ द इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ इलेक्शन इन अ डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री. सो द आंसर इज इम्पॉर्टेंस ऑफ इलेक्शन इन अ डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री, फ्री एंड फेयर इलेक्शंस आर द एसेंशियल पार्ट ऑफ एनी डेमोक्रेसी. डेमोक्रेसी विदाउट इलेक्शन कैन नॉट बी इमेजिन्ड. इन आवर कंट्री इलेक्शंस आर हेल्ड एज पर द provisions and norms laid down by the Constitution of India. Free and fair elections strengthen the very roots of the democratic structure. So this is the answer of lesson number 5, question number 5. Now BOQs of this chapter. How far will the right to election illiteracy from our country? So the right to education will eradicate illiteracy from our country when no citizen shall be denied admission to any educational institution on grounds of religion, race, caste or language. Now next, second, choosing the right representative is the key to successful democracy. Explain the suitable examples. Yes, it is the key to successful democracy because we ourselves electing our leaders in fair elections. In the absence of the free and fair election, no democratic country can be survived. So my dear students, these are the answers of lesson number 8. So today in this video I have completed your lesson number 7 and lesson number 8. In my next video I will give you question answer exercises of lesson number 9 and 10. So don't miss your next video also. Okay, it is sufficient. You have to complete your work today. Have a nice day. Take care.